My friend Rick bought a bunch of these chairs and the leg broke off on this one. He said he paid $500 each for these chairs, and I told him, well, I can fix it for half of that. The reason this chair broke was partially defective design and partially manufacturing defect. You can see a glue line right here, so this is the direction that the board originally went in, and the grain on here just went a little bit crooked. So this is essentially parallel grain in this curly wood. And so it broke off very easily when this was hit. So with the curly grain of the wood, that makes it easy to get that light to stick exactly where it needs to be. But I'm going to put a clamp on the end just to make sure that leg doesn't want to slide towards the end. And I put way too much glue in there just to be on the safe side. With the glue stronger than the wood, this is now good as new, which unfortunately isn't good enough. So I routed some grooves in here and here, and the idea is to put a straight grain piece of wood in here to reinforce all that grain that's going in the wrong direction. So this is the outside curve of the leg, and I know I cut this deep, so now I just have to score for where the inside of that curve is going to be. And once again, I'm using an excessive amount of glue to fill in any gaps that I might have. So with careful work and a sharp chisel, it's possible to flush cut without damaging the surrounding finish. Except for right here, but that's where I slipped with the router. So even if you never want to be an artist, some artist paints can be really handy for this type of repair. Well, this repair is all done, and in terms of a home workshop, one of the most cost-effective things you can do is repair furniture. Except I did this one for free.